New research reveals that flaxseed lignans may lower risk of breast cancer. Studies over the past 5 years have accelerated knowledge concerning possible dietary strategies for overcoming the onslaught of breast cancer. And while it may be that drug companies have their own vested interest in synthetic treatments, as is popular opinion among many underground health circles, these 6 studies show a perseverance among scientists to unveil whether one particular nutrient is worth your while to increase the lifespan and decrease the risk of you or a loved one being afflicted by the epidemic called breast cancer. Lignans have been the subject of much excitement, and what they are a major class of phytoestrogens, followed by isoflavones. Phytoestrogens are dietary plant-sourced xenoestrogens. Xeno meaning foreign, as in foreign to the body. They're not actually hormones, but imitators. They look and act like our real hormones, but can be known to act as inhibitors of estrogen. And this turns out to be a potentially good thing. Experts believe this action of lignans may be invaluable in reducing lifetime exposure to estrogen. And today that's considered a key component in developing breast cancer. But until recently, they didn't have empirical evidence needed to call it a breakthrough. And as studies continue to develop, don't be swayed by the headlines alone. See the results straight out of the lab. Find out what foods in particular you may want to increase in your diet. And stay tuned. As the excitement multiplies, there will be much more where this came from soon. So let's take a look at the history of the discoveries from 2008 to 2013. In 2008, it was found that lignin and isoflavones reduced the risk in overweight premenopausal women. Lignans and isoflavones became a main focus for the study to determine if consumption of phytoestrogens could be associated with a reduced risk of breast cancer. And researchers distributed a questionnaire to determine the dietary habits of about 6,500 women in Ontario aged 25 to 74. And the study found that lignin and overall phytoestrogen consumption was associated with a reduced risk of breast cancer, but only in overweight premenopausal women. In postmenopausal women, there was no significant association. The research team concluded that dietary lignin may well be linked to reduced risk of breast cancer among premenopausal women, but that weight could modify the association. In 2010, it was found that no significant associations between phytoestrogens and breast cancer risk at all. And in this study conducted by Epic Norfolk, researchers examined whether there was a relationship between dietary phytoestrogens and breast, prostate, and colorectal cancers, again, by conducting a scientific study. They concluded that there was no significant association between phytoestrogen intake and breast cancer. So, according to those observations, the phytoestrogens were neither causing nor preventing the disease. However, the populations they studied had notably small amounts of phytoestrogens in their diets overall. It might seem at this point that the researchers are chasing their tails. Yet, interest in xenohormones did not wane. And from here, studies would move out from the distant observations of populations to the lab, where we can actually watch the action under a microscope. In 2012, it was found that cancer cell spread was reduced by flaxseed lignans. Two ideas collided to provide scientists with a considerable lead. By now, flaxseeds had become known for their health benefits, including heart health and even cancer prevention. Another important food on the scene was sprouts. Sprouting causes a decrease in anti-nutrients and an increase in macro and micronutrients. And researchers at North Dakota State University took a really good look at the in vitro effects of flaxseed sprouts on human breast cancer cells. The results were encouraging. The sprouts significantly reduced growth and induced cancer cell death. And this was the discovery researchers were hoping for, potentially making flaxseed sprouts part of a dietary strategy to reduce the risk of breast cancer. In the same year, on the other side of the world, in India, scientists isolated out the lignans derived from flaxseeds in the body. The flaxseed lignans effectively inhibited tumor growth, stopped the spread in the blood cells and the lymphatic system. And it also prevented movement through the body, thus blocking cancer cell proliferation. This year in 2013, it was found that flaxseeds were officially associated with the reduced breast cancer risk. And this year, the EPIC Norfolk study came back for more. They examined and developed a database for the diets of over 300,000 women aged 35 to 70 years from 10 European countries. Their disappointing conclusion said, this study shows no association between flavonoid and lignin intake and breast cancer risk overall, or after taking into account menopausal status and breast cancer hormone receptors. So what could this mean? Is it possible that the observed effect in vitro are not isolating in the body? Notably, whereas our two previous studies looked at lignans specifically from flaxseeds, this study didn't seem to hone in on any particular food sources at all. This is notable and important. Another study in Canada looked not at overall lignin or phytoestrogen consumption, but specifically at that from flaxseeds alone. After observing a diet of around 3,000 women with breast cancer and 3,000 without, the team reported consumption of flaxseeds was associated with a significant reduction in breast cancer risk, as was consumption of flaxseed bread. In fact, there was a 28% reduced risk in postmenopausal women who consumed at least a quarter cup of flaxseeds per month. Both post- and premenopausal women saw a 26% risk reduction consuming just one slice of flax bread weekly. However, the latter group saw no significant reduction from eating the whole seed. So how much do you need? Lignin food sources include bran, whole grains, seeds, nuts, and legumes, but most of these only offer up to 1 milligram per 100 grams, whereas flaxseeds provide 335 milligrams. The study showed results with approximately 5 milligrams a day or 160 milligrams a month. That's about a teaspoon a day, with whole seeds being ineffective for premenopausal women. According to these results, both groups will do well to have a slice of flaxseed bread a day, and postmenopausal women can meet the grade with a teaspoon of seeds daily. Compare those results to a report published by the Flax Lignin Information Bureau, where Jocelyn Mather says 50 milligrams per day or one teaspoon is a safe and tested daily dose. So what are the sources of flax lignans? It's a great question. Flax oil, surprisingly, is not typically a concentrated source of lignans, unless the manufacturer specifies otherwise on the label. It may be that eating the seeds whole makes them less easily digestible and active constituents less absorbed, so no whole seeds. It's recommended that you get your flax in bread or fresh ground seeds at home. Supplementation may also be an option. So that's it for now. Please share this important information with family and friends. Don't forget to follow us on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. I'll see you next time.